strategist Paul Begala and former George W. Bush White House Chief of Staff Andrew Card. Paul, was this about election 2012, or was it the opening salvo in the bargaining that is no doubt to come about the budget?
Well, look, a little of both. I mean, when the president, like, comes downstairs in the morning and has orange juice, it's about 2012 and re-election. Every president cares desperately about being re-elected. But I was really struck. I thought Congressman Ryan, he's missing a chance here. I thought the president went out of his way to be fair. Of course, his speech was rooted in principle. This guy's got real principles. He's not going to allow Paul Ryan and the Republicans to end Medicare as we know it in order to pay for tax cuts for the rich. He's not going to squander the kinds of investments we have to make the economy grow. But we got to tackle the deficit. It really just means it's hard to do, but it's easy to analyze. We have to raise taxes and cut spending. And if anybody tells you you only have to do one of those things, that person's intellectually dishonest. Paul Ryan, intellectually dishonest. He's pretending that we can cut our way out of it, and he's not telling you that he actually wants to make these cuts so that we can give spectacular tax breaks to millionaires and billionaires. It's not going to fly politically.
Andy Card, not only was he pretty tough on Paul Ryan, he was tough on your former boss, former president, essentially blaming your administration for all the financial problems that this administration is now facing.
Well, first of all, I thought the president's speech was more political than it was policy. And
how so?
Not only that, the first 2,700 words centered around setting the stage for a political discussion rather than setting the stage to really reform our government and bring deficits under control. And then what he did offer was a lot of gimmicks. He even talked about it in the context of 12 years when Washington works on a 10-year rule for most budgets. And that's the old bird rule. It's what's been around for a long time. So he's asking us compare apples, the Ryan plan, to oranges, the Obama plan. And really, they're not even the same. They're not even in the same game. And so I think the president really is kind of misleading. He's got a lot of gimmicks. He's not looking to solve the problem. And he really pushes the burden on to future political generations, not on the political generation that is serving in Washington right now. So I think that it was not the best policy objective for the president to have. Instead, it was a political objective that he put forward.
Paul, you didn't hear much anything really about Social Security, which is obviously a major issue moving forward in terms of the economics.
Well, it is, but it's actually not a huge driver of the deficit. Social Security, I think, well, not in my word, I think, but even the actuaries say overall is in pretty good shape. Little minor changes in Social Security. The real problem are this debt and deficit, and Medicare is a huge driver of that, but so is the lack of revenue. So is the fact that we keep cutting taxes for rich people. Yeah, like me and President Obama said it like himself as well. I mean, the notion, by the way, that 12 years is too long to cut the spending, but Mr. Ryan's proposal, our viewers should know, does not come into balance for 50 years. It's a Trojan horse. It's not about the deficit. The president, I think, tried to make an honest cut at the deficit by saying, duh, we have to cut spending and raise taxes. Mr. Ryan wants to eliminate Medicare as we know it. The Wall Street Journal newspaper said it would essentially end Medicare in order to pay for tax breaks for, you know, billionaire polluters. I mean, that's not a deficit approach. That is a reordering of our national values to say that billionaires need more welfare and senior citizens on Medicare need less health care.
Paul, don't you see it amazing, though, that here we are, the president is actually debating Paul Ryan's proposal when the president should be leading the country. Instead, he's responding to Paul Ryan rather than offering real tough solutions that'll make a difference. And Paul Ryan did a great service. He changed the debate. He said, let's talk about really bringing fiscal discipline and let's have an honest debate about it. The president, you know, starts addressing Paul Ryan, but he does it in the context of politics rather than policy.
Look, he can't do enough to stop this Paul Ryan budget. It would destroy Medicare to give tax breaks to the rich. And Mr. Ryan, he's a charming guy. Everybody says he's a nice guy.
He's a smart guy.
He is ruthlessly intellectually dishonest. He's pretending that a plan, his plan, okay, we all agree doing nothing is a disaster, right, Andy? Doing nothing soars the debt and deficit. Ryan's plan is worse than doing nothing. The Congressional Budget Office looked at this and said, compared to doing nothing, the Ryan plan increases the debt even more over the first 10 years because he front loads all these tax cuts for the rich. You're not a serious deficit hawk. if you're talking about more tax cuts for the rich. You're just not. You just can't. I mean, it's like Charlie Sheen talking about drug rehab.
Congressman Ryan and the Republicans in Congress have said, let's have an honest debate about reforming government, changing the way we spend, changing our entitlement programs, solving the problem in the short term so that we don't have a long-term burden that's going to be placed and change the whole nature of a country. I think that Congressman Ryan has done a great service. The president didn't provide the leadership that he should have provided back in December when Erskine Bowles and Alan Simpson got together and proposed something very, very real. And he could have embraced that, and that's what the debate could have been about. But instead, Paul Ryan is the one that steps forward, and the president is responding. And quite frankly, he's not living up to the challenge that Paul Ryan put out there.
Andy, for you, are all tax cuts, any tax raising on the wealthy or allowing the Bush tax cuts to expire for the wealthiest Americans, that's completely off the table for you?
No. First of all, we just extended the Bush tax cuts for 2 years. And here the president is going out on television saying, we're going to increase taxes in 2 years. If you're a small businessman and you're being taxed at the individual rate, that means your rates are going to go up. So you're likely to husband your resources now, not employ people when we need more people employed in America, not making decisions to invest in the economy. Instead, worry about the tax increases that will come at the end of the expiration of these Bush tax cuts. It's the wrong time to play that psychology when you're trying to grow an economy. And that's not good leadership from our president.
Paul, I want you to be able to
respond. It's political, but it's not good leadership.
Yeah, if tax cuts for the rich created jobs, we wouldn't be in this mess. I worked for a president. I helped him balance the budget. He did it, but I played a tiny role in that White House, and he balanced the budget. We handed it off to Mr. Card's boss, Mr. Bush. The American people foolishly gave them a Republican House, a Republican Senate, a Republican White House.
When the baton was handed to George W. Bush, the country was sliding into a recession, and you know that, and it was the tax cuts that President Bush put in place in June of 2001 that got the economy back on the right track.
We had a balanced budget, and we had an enormous surplus
the
building up.
The bubble had burst before you left office.
Paul, I want you to be responding. We got to go.
Yeah, the Clinton economy, the Clinton Democrats balanced the budget. The Bush Republicans created this deficit. Now they're using the debt that they created as a Trojan horse so they can destroy Medicare to give more tax breaks for the rich. That's not a deficit program. That is a radical reordering of our country. I was proud of our president today standing up saying, I will not let you destroy Medicare to give tax breaks to the rich.
Games, gimmicks, and a timeline that doesn't work.
Which is what we got for 8 years from your boss, Andy.
Andy Card, Paul Begala, gentlemen, thank you.